And we are back on the Zero Hour. Joining us now to talk about those Social Security field office closings is Witold Skwierczynski, president of the AFGE, National Council of Social Security Administration Field Operations Locals. They represent the government employees involved. And first of all, thank you for joining us.
You're welcome. I'm glad to be here.
And secondly, did I do okay on pronunciation?
Yeah, you did really good. It's all phonetic.
All right.
Polish W's are V's and CZ's are like CH's, so you nailed it.
Thank you. I've been to Poland, actually, so I went with a labor group there a few times. So glad to have you on the program, and we've been talking a lot here about the closing of the field offices and how that's denying people something they paid for, basically. But for you guys, you're seeing it at working level, at day-to-day level. So tell us, what are your folks seeing? What has the SSA or Social Security Administration been doing with these field offices?
Well, in the last 3.5 years or so, they've closed about 80 offices. And they've closed, these are 80 community-based field offices that are open 5 days a week. They've also closed 500 part-time offices. We call them contact stations, where we send a representative, usually in a remote area, like a rural area, for maybe a day a week or a day a month or a day a quarter, depending on the place, how often they go. They've closed almost all of those sites. People who live in those communities no longer have an option to face-to-face service unless they're willing to travel to another location. In some cases, let's say like Ketchikan, Alaska would be the most radical change, that they closed the office. It's on an island. You'd have to fly to Juneau to get face-to-face service. In other cases, you know, the offices are maybe a couple miles away, and unfortunately, when SSA closed these offices, they didn't take into account public transportation or other commuting options, and nor did they make any attempt to communicate with the public about the public's desires regarding community-based services.
So you're really, and in some of these cases, when they close that field office, look, even if you're not in Alaska, older people, disabled people, taking public transportation a few miles away is no simple job. And you know, we've been telling folks that, look, you know, if you need documentation or anything else, a new card, whatever, it's not a simple thing. So what do you think they ought to do? Do you think they ought to be reopening all these offices? Obviously, Congress is pressing on their budget, and that's part of the problem. What would you guys like to see happen here?
Yeah, we think they should reopen all the closed offices. We've had hearings in the Senate Aging Committee this year, and they've been criticized by their own Inspector General's office for not having a plan for office closures. There's legislation pending, both in the House and the Senate. Congressman Higgins has introduced a bill in the House, and Senator Schumer in the Senate, which would require the agency to, if they do contemplate closing an office, that they provide criteria that they would explain. They have to provide a study what the effect would be on the community of the office closure, what alternate service the members of the community could have regarding face-to-face service. They would have to delineate the impact on employees and on the agency itself. They would also be required to have public hearings before they could close an office so that the public could weigh in on the office closure. And they'd have to have notice, public notice, and notice to Congress sufficiently in advance for there to be an appropriate debate about the whether that community-based office should remain open. So I think, you know, I think since they didn't use that kind of criteria in closing these offices, what we would seek is that they reopen the offices, and when they do, you know, develop criteria, and when they do think that an office should close, they use the guidelines that are in this pending legislation.
You know, it just gets me. We're talking with Witold Skwierczynski of the AFGE. It just gets me that they're closing these offices at a time when we're going to see a huge wave of people retiring. So people are going to need them more than ever. And, you know, when people continue to need to, when we've already got a year's delay, and for example, in in disability claim appeals, that sort of thing out there. It seems like a crazy time to be cutting back. Is there anything, I guess we'll just close with this, is there anything that listeners can do to keep the pressure up to stop this closing trend they're doing?
Yeah, you could go on the AFGE.org website, and we have and there's a Save Our Social Security site on there. And go on that site, and there's the bills that I mentioned from Congressman Higgins and Congress and Senator Schumer are located there. Public can read them. There's also an ability there where you can send an email message to your congressman or call your congressman or write a letter to your community newspaper with some talking points and guidelines about the public's attitude about this attempt to shut down community-based service. Now, you know, the agency thinks that the internet is a good substitute for filing claims face-to-face, but our clientele, disabled people and seniors, are the least the people that use the internet the least, and even those who do use the internet, many don't have the expertise or the knowledge of internet services to wade through a complex Social Security applications. Our people review these claims right now that are filed on the internet, and they find significant amounts of errors. Over 95% have to be recontacted. There's mistakes all over the place, and mistakes that people are making are mistakes with regards to when to begin their benefits on the retirement side, on the disability side, mm-hmm. when their disability began, or all the conditions that they have with regards to their disability. And these kinds of mistakes lead to a potential permanent loss of benefits for folks. So I would advise the public, don't use the internet to file a claim. Call the 800 number and set up an appointment in your local community-based office. Complain about office closures. Go to our AFG.org website. Complain to your congresspeople about your office closures and demand that your office and your community remain open.
Right, absolutely. You just got to have a person who can guide you through the process and knows what you can and can't do.
Yeah, our people are experts, and they can. They'll give you advice about when is the best time to start your benefits and what you should put on your disability application so that you have the best chance of having a reasonable decision on your claim.
Well, we'll keep encouraging people to make those phone calls, and we'll keep encouraging people to go to the website and write those letters and contact our representatives, too. Thanks so much for joining us. We've been talking with Witold Spierczynski of the AFGE. Thank you for coming on the show.
Letting me be on.
I'm Richard R.J. Eskow, and we will be right back. This is The Zero Hour.